You're welcome to the DTU studio. In today's Rubaroo, we bring you face to face with another alumnus of our Delhi Technological University, Mr. Ambareesh Murty. Mr. Ambareesh Murty is founder and CEO of Pepperfry.com. So, Mr. Murty, you have been a student of our Delhi Technological University, and we are proud that you are doing so wonderful. I would like to ask you, which year did you pass out from here?
I passed out in 1994. At that time, we used to have a campus at Kashmiri Gate, and it used to be called the Delhi College of Engineering. So 1994, and I'm a civil engineer by training.
Yeah. And you are a civil engineer by training. Mm. And then you shifted on to marketing, and you shifted into management, then you shifted into manufacturing, and now you are into a corporate. How was this journey of yours?
It was very interesting. I think I joined IIM Calcutta straight from DC, right?
Okay.
So I passed out of DC and I joined management. And it was a fantastic time. I mean, I think the 4 years that I spent at DC, I let's say lived and breathed with people who were amongst the smartest people I ever knew. They were amongst the funnest people that I ever knew. I think that contributed a lot to my overall journey. And it taught me how to approach new problems. It taught me how to approach new sectors, new industries. And therefore, you know, once I passed out of management, you'll find that I did a lot of FMCG. I used to be an FMCG guy.
Okay.
Then I was in financial services. And then I used to run India's largest e-commerce company, and then I decided to start on my own. So it's been, I think, the thing that I learned the most and I enjoyed the most was taking on new challenges every single day.
And today, as far as startups are concerned, you are amongst the leaders in this startup, I suppose.
I think it's very important for us to be humble. And I think that the only reason we are there is because I was fortunate that a bunch of really interesting and very intelligent people decided to work with me. I have often said I take the credit for what they've achieved. I also think that we, like all businesses, all let's say everything that happens that's good, we put in a lot of hard work. Intensity, passion is something that's very intrinsic to the way Pepperfry has been made. And yes, I would like to think that we also got lucky, because you know, eventually, there is everything that we can do by ourselves, and there's that 1% that also matters, and that also we got. So I think it was a great journey. It's been a great journey.
It's been a great journey. Pepperfry is basically into home decor, furniture, and all that.
Yeah.
And you are a civil engineer.
Yeah.
How come you thought of this sort of a startup?
So I understood e-commerce quite well,
okay.
Right? When I was running India's largest e-commerce company, I had sold a lot of mobile phones and digital cameras. And I somehow did not want to keep selling a lot of mobile phones and digital cameras. What I also understood was that it's very important for any business, especially in e-commerce, as e-commerce evolves, to be built in a manner which is highly differentiated. And differentiation comes from selecting very clearly what is it that you wish to do. In my case, that meant what was the vertical that I would want to approach. Now, as you might see from my appearance, I have very little fashion sense. I do not wear any jewelry.
That itself is a fashion.
So I have very little fashion sense. I hardly wear any jewelry. I think the thing I'm very passionate about has always been my home. I love the furniture that I get. I've been loving the furniture that I get at home. I'm a avid book reader, therefore the bookcases, everything is specifically picked, hand-picked by my wife and I. Every piece of decor. So that's an area which, you know, we've been very interested in. Mm-hmm. And because I was very interested in that space, I figured that, look, if I'm going to build a business, let me build a business about something which I'm really interested in. And that's furniture and home decor.
And then, like many of our alumni are into startups, they are into very different sort of trades and businesses.
Yeah.
Come across any of those prominent guys?
There are, I mean, I think all of them have done way better than I have. I think all of them are fantastic folks. It's one of the things that's very interesting. I think DTU, DCE has a very strong alumni network, especially when it comes to startup founders in India. You know, First Cry Supam is ex of DCE, DTU. Vijay from Paytm is ex of DCE, DTU. There are several folks across several the startup folks. Infrastructure or the ecosystem. They're actually DC
big,
guys.
Big Basket.
Big Basket big has basket. A DC association. So it's I think, you know, we have been one of those, how do I put it, quiet campuses where our alumni have done quite well. Our education is fantastic. And our folks go on to lead and do fantastic things in the corporate world and in the startup world. And I think, yeah, I'm very proud of where I came from. And yeah.
I don't know, there's something very unique about this institution, which I feel.
Yeah.
Like when students come after plus two
yeah.
and they enter all, not only this institution,
yeah.
Delhi Technological University,
yeah.
Which is one of the most prestigious
yeah.
universities
yeah.
In India now, but whichever they join. When they are doing their plus two and competing for their entrance test, they are just like they have those camel's goggles
yeah.
and
yeah.
They are not permitted to see yeah. around any
yeah.
place.
Yeah.
And when they join here,
yeah.
I think this place provides them a great opening to think creatively.
I completely agree with you. And I think it's the ability to think out of the box. And one very important factor, which I think, so I have always maintained that success for anybody is a marathon and it's not a sprint. Very often our education system, especially in 12th standard, is about teaching us how to sprint really well. I think the thing that is required to win marathons and not win sprints is to have a very strong understanding of yourself as an individual and to have a sense of humility mm-hmm. about anything that you do. And I do think DCE folks, and I have interacted with so many of DCE, DTU folks across mm-hmm. India, I mean, batchmates and so on. I think we are a fairly humble lot. I mean, and I know it sounds like a not so very humble thing to say, but I think humility is something that gets somehow becomes part of our DNA. And that's what helps in the marathon, right? I mean, because, you know, if it's a sprint, then you got to want to win every single race that you're running. But in a marathon, it's fine. I mean, sometimes you run a little slower, sometimes you run a little faster. Mm-hmm. But what matters is at the end of that marathon, who's the winner? And I think a lot of that you see also in the startup ecosystem today. I mean, mm-hmm. a lot of what's talked about is, you know, who raised what money and what in what short span of time. But that's not what's building businesses in the long term. What is building businesses in the long term is the marathon that you run.
Marathon,
it's marathon. How you create a business which sustains and is differentiated and, you know, can control its own destiny over 25, 30, 100 years.
Mm-hmm.
And that's something that I think, especially in my case, I would think DTU has been a lot towards contributing to that state of mind. I think it's that inherent sense of humility and knowing that, you know, there's always you got to try harder and keep trying is something that DTU, DCE built in me. Yeah.
Where were you born and brought up?
I am, it's complicated. I am half Tamilian, half Telugu.
Okay.
Born and brought up in Delhi.
Okay.
And then, you know, now work in Bombay where the head office of Pepperfry is at Bombay. And my mother, mm-hmm. though she is a Tamilian, was born and brought up in UP.
Okay.
So it's a let's just say that I'm part of a very cosmopolitan family.
Yeah.
There is some part of the whole world. I'm married to a Malayali.
so
my son's like really interesting.
Telugu and it's Malayali.
I've covered all the southern streets.
Working Maharashtra.
Yeah, the only way I now need to figure is how do I. So if my son marries a Kannadiga, then we've covered all of the south.
Okay, and, yeah. of it's so nice. Yeah. That's the sweetness of our country, in fact.
Totally. Yeah.
The way our new generation, our generation is going ahead, it's so fantastic.
Thank you.
Awesome. That's really good. And. All your study here, when you were studying here, did you find it something difficult because you came from that different background and then you shifted on to
culturally?
Culturally.
No, not at all. I think I was, I think it was the community of the university just, you know, embraced you. You're just part of the community. I mean, there's no, at that point in time, I don't think we even thought whether which part of the country we were from and so on. We were all part of DCDTU. I mean, and that was it. I had some of my most fun times in DCDTU. I mean, I have always thoroughly enjoyed.
Does your family have a business background?
So no, I mean, my surname is Murty. It is not Bansal or Agarwal or that.
Okay.
My mother was a scientist. My father had passed away when I was very young.
Okay.
And I guess the anything I learned about business, I learned from the institutes that I went to, which is DCDTU and I am Calcutta.
Okay, so whatever you have achieved in your business is through your company, through the friends, through the people you have been
through people I worked with. It's through companies I worked for. It's through colleges I've been through. Is business in my blood? So I think in 5 generations before mine, nobody in my family would have.
That's a great message to all youngsters. It's not necessary to have a business background to get into
necessary.
It.
It's not necessary.
Rather, it's not necessary to have a background of any sorts for getting into anything.
I agree.
Could be anything from background and you could reach anywhere in the world.
I agree. I think it's all about. It's about the fight you put. It's about the work you do. It's about being humble about what you've achieved, and it's about being confident about what you've not achieved and going ahead and doing it. And that's the journey. I mean, you know, finally, it's all about the journey. It's about how much fun you have during the journey. You will win, you will lose. Hopefully, you will win more than you will lose.
You know, let me be informal and tell you. As a child, myself, I used to aspire to be in army, right?
Yeah.
And I joined a Sanic school also.
Oh, yeah.
But then I had my color vision defect, red and green.
Right.
So eventually, you can't get into army.
Yeah.
And I came into theater.
Yeah. Yeah.
So from army, my destiny led me to theater.
Yeah.
But it is your work, it is your passion.
It is.
That leads us.
That's how it works.
Anywhere. Our DTU also has started off with startup ventures for students, and we have created a cell called TBI for it. You must have heard a bit.
Yeah,
about
I was hearing from the Vice Chancellor about it. I think it's a very interesting initiative.
So we already have a company registered for it, and then the university has put up some amount in it. And we have already 4 ventures joining in for that.
Yeah.
And lately, we have 8 more ventures out of the 53 which we had applied.
Yeah. So, one of the things that I think strikes me is as something we can do is I think DCDTU is lucky to have some great alumni, right?
Oh, yeah.
And it has a fantastic bunch of alumni. There must be thousands of us out there. Folks from DCDTU do well in life, normally. It's the nature of our education.
They do well.
I think we as alumni should look to figure out a mechanism by which we can, you know, not only support endeavors that are happening from students from within DC, but also look to create an ecosystem where entrepreneurship overall can flourish from not only folks from DC, but DCDTU, but also students, younger entrepreneurs, even older entrepreneurs from across the country. And I think that's something that I would love to participate in. It could start small with mentorship, it could start with subjectivity like mentorship. Or it could be highly objective, like putting your money where your mouth is, which is, you know, making investments, figuring out which companies will help, or which work, which will succeed or not succeed, and help them in doing that. So I think those are things that alumni can do a lot of, and I mean, I'd be happy to participate in it.
That's fantastic. Yeah. And your pepper fries on the top of the world, and so you are on the top of the world.
No, I'm lucky, and
God bless you. I'm also one of your fans. I did make a purchase online for your pepper fry, and I feel so privileged that today I'm face to face with you.
The privilege is entirely mine. Thanks for having me.
And any message for our students?
I would like to tell them, think big. I think it's only if you think big that you can do big. But when you're thinking big, just remember that all of the success normally is in details. So think big, but always pay attention, get your details perfectly right. And I think you will have a fantastic journey, a great time, and build great businesses.
Thank you, Ambareesh. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much
for being with us. Thanks. And God bless. Best wishes to you and your Pepperfry.
Thank you very much.
God bless.
Thank you.